So if you have a thorax curve to the right, that means your body is bending left, as you see here, and the ribs are much closer together on the left side. And if you have a thorax curve to the left, that means your body is bending to the right, and the ribs are much closer together on that side. As the vertebra twist or rotate, the ribs that attach to each vertebra are dragged along, causing the ribs on one side of the body to push backward, giving the characteristic rib hump appearance seen in thoracic scoliosis. The front ribs on the opposite side are pushed forward, often making the chest appear more prominent on that side. So let's take a look at the rubber model that I've created here. It points if you can guess how I made this. This is a slice through the human body. If we were to saw from the belly button through to the spine at the back, we'd take a slice and then look down from over top. Where my finger's pointed here, this is the back, one single vertebra. And the front is the sternum, where the ribs attach on the left and right side. They go all the way around the sides of your body, arc in, and attach to the vertebra on either side near the front. Now, if you happen to have a thoracic scoliosis curving right, in other words, your left shoulder drops down, it's important to recognize the body's also twisting. So as you're bending left, the vertebra are also twisting you to the right or rotating right. So let's look what happens. When the vertebra rotates to the right, you get a rib hump on the same side at the back, just like that. And you might have a prominence to the opposite side at the front, the blue sternum. Now, if you curve left, in other words, the right shoulder is lower than the left, you're bending to the right, there's also a corresponding twist in the body. Let's look what happens. Right bend with left twist. If we twist the vertebra or rotate them left, you get a rib hump on the left side at the back and possibly a prominence to the opposite chest, the blue sternum to the right. And this is what they look like, all three examples. You may notice you've got a rib hump on one side and a prominent chest on the opposite side, and maybe even a hollowing on one of the chest sides. Now make sure you spend some time in front of a mirror. This is complicated. Come back, rewatch this video several times.